Rising COE prices, $5,000 increase in VES penalties, shrinking COE quota. Bad news, bad news, bad news. So, for those of us car lovers, does it mean it's the end of our dream to own a new car? Hi, I'm Galvin from VAuG. First of all, before we start this video, I have to caveat a few things. Although VAuG has been in the automotive business for 3.5 decades, and we know something about car price trends, that doesn't mean that we'll always be right in our prediction. So, while we think that COE will invariably go up in the next 2 to 3 years based on trends and other telltale signs, I personally still wish that we are also wrong in this. Having put this out of the way, let me share with you why we think cars will only get more expensive. Oh, if you haven't watched me talk about the COE trend in 2021, please look for the video I've included in the link below. Anyway, after you've watched that video, you will understand why we think COE is on a 3-year uptrend, which already started late last year. The possibility of 90K COE or even higher is very real this time. At this time in 2021, this possibility of higher COE is further made worse by two things. First, VES penalties for cars with higher emissions will be increased by $5,000 starting from July 2021. That means a car like the Mercedes-Benz GLC 300, without doing anything, will be $5,000 more expensive after 30th June 2021. Second, and more technical, is the return of COEs accumulated from the bidding exercise that was suspended in April to June in 2020 due to the circuit breaker. The last 3,000 or so COEs will complete its redistribution by July 2021. What this means is that from August, we will see a much smaller pool of COEs being released. And the pool of COEs will continue to diminish in the quarters ahead, as I've discussed, all the way until 2024, due to the nature of the population of 10-year-old cars being scrapped over these few years. So, our advice from VAuG is this. If you are looking to change your car to a new one, especially if you aren't looking to get the luxury category cars that cost upwards of, let's say, 150K, you should really consider doing it ASAP, maybe even before August. Because if there are no upward adjustments to the number of new COEs being released, or favorable change in some sort of rebate or tax structure, your humble Honda shutter might cost you 130K in a short 3 years. Some might say this is fear-mongering, or we are doing this to create a sense of urgency. I see it as a form of public service announcement based on our experience analysis. Sure, I might be wrong in the short term where there could be fluctuations downwards, but we at VAuG are very certain, along with most dealers out there, that COE will not recover to 2018, 2019, or even the 2020 levels for many more years, if at all. Feel free to come down to our showroom to have a discussion with us on this topic, or perhaps even start a conversation in the comments below. But for those of you who are ready to change to a new car, or even buy a new one, you should really do it soon.